Yeah, it was funny. I was talking to a fellow minister last night, and we were talking about writing our talks, and I said, my sweet congregation just really wants me to tell a joke, regardless of how bad it is. So get ready for another bad one. All right, so married for 50 years, Gertrude and Elmer decided to go on a long-awaited vacation. And however, their vacation was interrupted to go to the dentist. I want a tooth pulled, and I don't want any freezing because I'm in a big hurry, Gertrude said. Just extract the tooth as quickly as possible, and we'll be on our way. And the dentist was quite impressed. You're certainly a brave woman, he said. Which tooth is it? And Gertrude turned to her husband, Elmer, and said, show him your tooth, dear. Yeah. See? So today is the continuation of the summer series that I came up with called Wise Words from TV All-Stars. And I really want to give a shout out to Edie and Jim for covering for the last couple of weeks. Can you give them some love? Because if you weren't here at the beginning, I've been down in Charlotte with my mom who is ill. So this week, I got to tell you, this is my favorite TV show. Yeah, and it's called This Is Us. How many of you have seen This Is Us? Okay, it's a Unity crowd. If you haven't, don't worry. I'm going to give you some context and you know around what I'm going to talk about today. But just FYI, the opening of season 3 starts on Tuesday, September 25th at 9 p.m. Just saying. And I just want to give you, too, because I heard about this from my dear, dear friend Lenny, and she made me swear that I would not watch one episode out of order. So if you want to, after this talk today, maybe you'll feel inspired to watch This Is Us, but what you want to do is go on NBC.com or you want to go to On Demand and watch episode 1, season 1, episode 2. Do not skip an episode because they go in and out of time, and it's so well done. Okay. But I do want to let you know it was chosen for the American Film Institute as one of the top 10 television programs of 2016. And in 2017, it received 10 nominations for the 69th Primetime Emmy Awards, including Outstanding Drama Series, with Sterling K. Brown, who is Randall, winning for Outstanding Lead Actor in a Drama Series, as well as receiving nominations for the Golden Globe Award for Best Television Series Drama and the Critics' Choice Television Award for Best Drama Series. It's good. So what I felt inspired to share with you today, and I got to tell you, this is the first time I've done this, so I hope that you'll just kind of, you know, work with me. You know, the video thing, you know, is an opportunity. And I really want to thank Edie for her help with that. She's so savvy. But what I really want to do today is to invite you into getting to know my favorite character of This Is Us, and his name is Randall. And so I want to get you kind of connected with him. But first, I think you need a basic overview of the show. All right. So Keith. Okay. So I'm going to just point out some characters here. All right, so up here in the upper left, this is Rebecca and Jack, and they get married, and they get pregnant with triplets. Now, you notice that there are two white babies and one black baby. There's a reason for this. During the birth of their triplets, one of the babies dies. And so what happens is that same day, Randall is born to two parents that have drug problems, and they feel that they can't raise this child. So the father, William, who is over here in the bottom right corner, that's him as older, William drops off Randall at the fire station. And so at the hospital, Rebecca and Jack are devastated that they've lost a child. But Jack goes down to the nursery and he meets the fireman who just dropped off Randall. And they have a conversation. And Jack knows immediately that this is their child. And eventually Rebecca comes around. She moves through her grief and she embraces this child and they adopt him. So here they are kind of moving through their, you know, school age years. And here are the children. This is Kevin on the end, and this is Kate in the middle, and there's Randall. And so I want to tell you a little bit about their relationship. You know, Jack, the father, was very much an anchor in the family and always taught the children that family comes first and that these kids need to love each other and stand by each other. The tricky part is Kevin, a nice-looking guy here, just grew up really insecure. He was always intimidated by Randall because Randall was always the smartest. Randall always did great in school. He always did everything perfectly. You know, he was brilliant. And so although Kevin became a TV star and then moved into live theater, he just remained very insecure. And he depended a lot on Kate. And there's Kate in the middle, and Kate also depended on Kevin a lot, and Randall, and she always struggled with her weight. That was a big issue. So growing up, Randall was always smarter than the other kids. He didn't have a whole lot of friends. Randall was just the child out of the three that was the easiest to raise. He was just easy, and he just tried so hard to belong. And so again, there's William, the biological father. So let's go back to this slide there. Okay, so Randall grows up to be a successful, very successful businessman. And here's his beautiful family. There's Beth, his wife, and Annie and Tess, his little girls. So the thing is, since Randall was adopted, he struggled his entire life with belonging, with feeling the need to be perfect in order to be loved and fit in. And he'd often have intense stress and anxiety. He'd have panic attacks because he was so intensely wired, you know, to be perfect, to do it just right, and to be in control. So today, as part of getting to know Randall more, I'm going to show you some of my favorite highlights from season one of This Is Us and invite you to connect with him and to experience who he is, because I really feel like Randall models having a brave heart and a loving spirit. And also, you know, as we get to know people on our journey, as we connect with them, we learn from them, and we just see what we can learn from each other. It's a mutual exchange. So in the storyline of the first season of This Is Us, Randall was always curious who his biological father was. And even though he adored his adoptive father, Jack, and Jack adored him, he wanted to feel that connection with the man who looked like him. And so Randall finally connects with his biological father after searching him out. And here's how that goes.
My name is Randall Peasing. I'm your biological son.
36 years ago, you left me at the front door of a fire station.
If you think I'm gonna forgive you.
I don't.
You know, you were right. I did just want to say screw you and storm out of here.
Well, go ahead.
Screw you.
Yep.
You want to meet your grandchildren?
If you throw me a stone, I will keep it.
Guys, this is your, William Hill.
Hi.
You have a hole in your pants.
Annie?
Isn't that what the kids do to be cool? They put holes in their pants, right?
Not like that.
I should have called. I didn't know how to say it out loud.
So?
He left me at a fire station, and I invited him into our home.
What's happening?
What's happening?
Okay, so that went well. So don't you love how Randall tries so hard to be mad? You know, he's hurt. This man dropped him off at a fire station 36 years before that, and he tries to be mad, but his heart wins out. I love his authenticity with his wife in this scene. And he wanted a connection more than he wanted to stay mad. So turns out that William has stage 4 stomach cancer. And so after this, William ends up moving in with Beth and the girls and becomes part of the family. And it's during this time that Randall starts to really get to know William. And William sees his son and his success and how wonderful he's turned out so well. But yet there's another side to Randall, the unhealed side. And so here we're going to see Randall's vulnerability.
The medication isn't working anymore. I don't want to do this to you.
I can take it. Do you want to stop the chemo, William?
The oncologist estimates he's only got a few more months. Our focus is making him more comfortable, whether that is pain management or nutrition or getting you access to hospice nurses.
Should we start digging his grave now or should we wait until there's an actual body?
Randall.
You know what, I have to get to work.
Good, Randall, you're here.
Sorry, it's a family thing.
I wanna split your accounts between you and Sanjay.
Look, Tyler, please, I'll bring my A game. I know I've been a little bit off lately,
Randall,
but no.
Randall, this is happening.
Kevin, 5 minutes.
Okay. Randall, hey.
I'm not gonna be able to make it tonight, man. I got caught up at the office.
Come on, are you serious?
I really wish I could be there. It's just one of those things, you know?
All right, whatever. All right, you'll see it eventually, all right?
Okay, then.
It's quite a shock to see you so vulnerable. You seem to have it all together.
My father, he kept it in check. Whenever I get too in my head, he'd take his hands and put them on both sides of my head, and he'd just say,
there you go, breathe with me.
And we just sit there, just breathing together until it passed.
Until it passed. Yeah, so in this scene, Kevin is making his live theater debut, and he's very vulnerable. And everyone's there except for Randall, and Randall's always there. Randall always shows up. And so in that moment, Kevin realizes what's happening with his brother, that he's having a panic attack. And he leaves. He doesn't even go on stage. And he goes to be with him. And so how many of us can relate, you know, to the persona that we put up? You know, here's Randall, and he's so successful outwardly. But inside, he struggles with not being enough. And trying to be in control and really, you know, with his worth and value. And so I just feel like it's something for us to possibly relate to, because I think it's epidemic in our culture about just not being enough and how much we strive. We strive to be perfect. So those unreasonable expectations that we put on ourselves, I feel like that's what Randall's demonstrating. And so... so after this, William and Randall take a road trip to William's hometown, where Randall is able to see how his father lived. His father loved music, wrote poetry. He was creative and vibrant and kind. And Randall gets to see the impact of his father's life, and it was very special. And it inspires him to start living his life in a different way. And William knew it would be their last trip together, so... And he knew he wouldn't come home alive. But here's a scene where William reflects back to his son, his worth, and Randall really lets it in. And I think Randall gets the connection to who he is and who he can be in this moment. It's really beautiful.
Roll all your windows down, Randall. Crank up the music. Let someone else make your bed. You deserve everything, Randall. My son. Just breathe. Come on now, breathe with me. There you go.
Dies with Beth Randall right by his side. And Randall's life is forever changed. And so this last video that I have shows him standing in his power and opening his true brave heart to the difference he gets clear as his to make from this transformation.
I gotta stop by the office. There's just something I gotta take care of.
Randall, thank God.
10 years, Tyler. I've worked here for 10 years. My father died, man. And on the day of his memorial, you sent a card with a one-line Hallmark message and a typed-out signature. You see, for days, I've been plagued by this question. How do I honor my father's legacy? And I realized I honor it by taking what I've learned from how he lived his life and having it shape the way I go on living mine. And so here it is, Tyler. I quit.
Hold on.
No hard feelings, man. Beth, I want to adopt a baby.
That's sweet. You can clap. It's good. Okay. So here's this beautiful character, and I just kind of want to recap what he modeled for us. I feel like Randall modeled having an open, brave heart. Yeah. A brave heart is a heart that loves hard. And Randall loved hard. It's a compassionate heart, and he just couldn't help himself. He let love take over. And another thing I think he modeled was he modeled forgiveness. He modeled letting go and being open to discovering the person, the father, the man that he forgave. And in that discovery, he found himself. At the heart of forgiveness is who we truly are. It's love. And Randall also, to me, modeled that we can so often be successful on the outside and still hold that unworthiness and not enough underneath. And the truth is, until we let that go, folks, I don't think we can ever be free. And for many of us, it's a lifelong journey. Because we are enough, and I believe one of our greatest healings is to know, claim, and express that truth. And Randall modeled how hard we try to be in control. And interestingly, when he felt out of control was when he found love and healing. He models what we can be, and not allowing the outer circumstances to determine how much he loves. What a beautiful thing. So how about this week we take Randall with us? And what about this week? Let's practice letting love lead the way. Yeah. Where are you being invited to be a brave heart? To be open to let go and be compassionate, to forgive, to love hard. And what underlying beliefs can we let go of to claim our enoughness? To claim our worth and our value, because, wow, we are enough. And I know I can say that, but it's the truth. And we hear it every week here in Unity. Hopefully you hear that, that you are whole and amazing and capable of doing every great thing. But the thing is, our work is to claim that and know that. So this week, can we let go and make space for love to lead the way? And what would be possible for us if we let love lead the way? And what's the difference we can make? So, how you doing? How's your heart? You okay? It's pretty touching, isn't it? You ought to see the rest of the episodes. Just have a Kleenex box by your television set. It is so true, it's so real, it's so beautiful. So I hope Randall has blessed you today. He certainly blessed me. So let's take a deep breath together. Yeah. And let's affirm. I am a brave heart. I let love lead the way and be the space from which I choose to act. And so it is. Blessings.